Matthew says, give us this day our daily bread. Luke says, give us day by day our daily bread. So give us is both. Our daily bread is both. This day or day by day? This day would only be asking for, as it says, just this one day. And you'd have to repeat this prayer every day. But Luke, you could say it's asking for every day. Give us day by day. Give us every day our daily bread. Give us day by day our daily bread. Give us day by day our daily bread. I don't know if I could put both. Give us this day by day. Has to be one or the other. Give us day by day, or give us this day. I think I'm going to go with day by day, because that includes more of an amount of time than just this day. I'll have from Luke day by. Only that second day would be both. I mean, if you're just going to compare two requests, right? If God is going to equally honor whichever one you ask for, but you can only ask one, are you going to say, please give me what I need for today? Or, please give me what I need every single day? Meaning, for the rest of the future, I pray that every day you'll give me what I need. Day by day, if that's what it means, that's a whole lot better of a prayer than just asking for one day. I pray that you would keep me safe today and never say that prayer again. You'd be safe for today, but tomorrow. But if you say, Lord, please keep me safe every single day for the rest of my life, until your will be done that I die, there's a lot more protection involved. So I think day by day is so much more inclusive and expansive of a prayer. I'm going with that. And forgive us our debts. And forgive us our sins. So, and forgive us our... both. For we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. So Luke has both sins and indebted. Matthew just has debt. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. That's interesting. So are we praying for God to forgive our sins? I guess you could say that's the same thing, because the wages of sin is death. So if you sin, you owe God your death. You owe him payment for that sin because you've wronged him. He made the world a certain way, and these are his parameters. And when you violate them, when you miss the mark, when you sin, you would owe him to fix it, repayment. And it's just death. That's the only way to pay for your sin. That's why Jesus had to die for us. Otherwise, everyone would just be dead and just go straight to hell. We needed a payment for our sin. It had to be death. So I guess it's kind of the same thing. Forgive us our sins. Forgive us our debts. Sin is a bit more clear, though. Forgive us our sins. You know, just because there is a difference in Luke, forgive us our sins as we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. I'm going to go with that, the way Luke has it. Instead of debts, I'm going to go with sins. Now, should I say, as we forgive, for we forgive everyone that is indebted to us? I think it should be as, because if I say for, that means that because we forgive others, therefore, God, you owe us to forgive us. Forgive us for I did that. It's like, because that's like works. Forgive me because as a result of doing this over here. We can talk about works-based salvation. I know James 2, Abraham was justified by works. But, praise God, I just watched a sermon about justification. I would recommend you listen to Mike Winger's explanation of works-based salvation. Justified doesn't necessarily mean you are made holy, or that you are sanctified, or that you are saved. For example, Jesus was talking about John the Baptist. Luke 7, verse 29, and all the people that heard him and the publicans justified God. That's proof. Justified does not necessarily mean you are saved. Because these publicans are not saving God. They're not putting righteousness on God. They're not covering sins for God. They're justifying God, meaning they are validating, if you will. They're saying, yes, God's way is right, because they were baptized with the baptism of John. That's what this verse says. All the people that heard him and the publicans justified God being baptized with the baptism of John. So Jesus is speaking positively of John. So like, oh, well, praise God. Yes, John was of God. They were baptized by John and they believe it was of God. He was a prophet from God. So they validated what John was doing, and also validated God by accepting John's baptism. It's a way of showing acceptance, right? Justified doesn't necessarily mean justification, that we are covered by Jesus' blood and therefore we are justified before God. No, it means verified. Like, here, I accept. Yes, what you did is good. Speaking about John the Baptist, or speaking about God from John the Baptist. I think that's the way that it was used in James. James 2, verse 21. Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he had offered Isaac his son upon the altar? Where it said justified here, it's just like how I showed you before. The publicans justified God. They weren't making God righteous. Was not Abraham our father justified by works? Abraham was not made righteous by his works. His faith was not improved by his works. He was verified. His faith was verified. It was shown to be evident by works. Was not Abraham our father justified by works? I don't know how many times I have to say this to make it clear. It's not his works that finished his salvation or that made his salvation more complete. It just showed. Abraham was verified by his works. That's what this use of justified means. So, all of that is the reason why I don't want to use for. We forgive everyone that is indebted to us. Therefore, God, you must forgive us. If that sounds like works. Because we've done this work, which is forgive others, which actually that might not really be a work, forgiving. But still, it says for. Because of this, forgive us. I would rather go with as from Matthew. And forgive us our sins as we forgive. Everyone that's indebted to us. So it's the same. It's not one leads to the other. It's equal. So I'm going to leave as. As we forgive. Right? For we also forgive. Actually, I can have also. As we also. That's from Luke. As we forgive our debtors. I think the more wordy way of saying this in Luke is better. For we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us instead of just debtors. I'm definitely going to go with everyone, not just our debtors. So yeah, I'll go with that. Luke, everyone that is indebted to us. And lead us not into temptation. That's both. But deliver us from evil. But deliver us from evil. Alright, that's both as well. Okay. Now, Matthew ends in, "For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen." I've heard that this is not in some of the older manuscripts. It was just added for some... I don't even know. But it's there. I'll just leave it. It's at least historical. It's not here in Luke. It just goes on to, "And he said to them, which of you shall be a friend and shall go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me 3 loaves. So all this is just Matthew. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And then he speaks about forgiveness, which he just ended in. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Oh, look at that. There's the works. It can't be works. I guess forgiveness is not a work. Yeah, alright. Forgiveness is not a work. But still, I'm going to have, as we also forgive everyone that's dead to us.